Don't do what I just did. Did. Let's burn this out. See, look, I burnt myself. I've got a white mark there. Look, little tiddly one. Okay. I'm just adding some of these crystals here, sort of, just so they look like they're poking out behind the flowers. What other ones have we got? Got a bead. Just add that there. Again, it's just all about filling in any gaps that you've got. That's all it is. Doesn't look white, it looks cream. I'll swap it over. Okay, so I'm just going to get some of my So what I've got here are some of the little bottles that you can get from Scrap Perfect. That one's got little stars in it, silver stars, and this one's got little white, like Aurora Borealis stars in them. So I'm going to add them with some micro beads to the middle of my and I don't know if any of you guys work with micro beads. Oh, they are fun because they slide everywhere. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to mix some of the stars and don't throw these bottles away either, and the white little iridescent and put them on there. These are Fab Four shaker cards as well, and keep these bottles. So I'm just going to mix this up. There we go. So we've got a nice sort of mixture. I'm going to use my glue. I'm going to dab some glue in the middle. Not too much. That's probably a bit too much. And I'm going to add some of the stars into the middle. Definitely. I don't know if you can see it, like so. Okay. And again, I'll leave those to dry. And then what I will do is I will stick them stick this one onto this one. Oops. At an angle to give me a 3D star. Let's get the not a pin. Where's the pin gone? So this one, I'm going to do the blue one on the top. So I'm going to stick. Yeah, I'm going to do it the right way around. So stick this one to this one. So, add some more glue to the middle. And then add some more of the mix. And just sort of, you know, push it in, tuck it in. So let that dry. They look really fab. Look. So again, I'm going to leave those to dry. Don't they look cool? I'm going to add some lace, I think, to the inside of here. Because I don't know if you remember in the film, what was the film? Oh, Lion, the Witch and the Wardrobe, which there's, I suppose I'm trying to base this version off of, or just it had sort of like a high back, but what I thought I could do is this has got like this trim has got bling, like bling bits on it, and I thought I could add that to maybe the inside of this to give it some sort of height at the back. And what I might do is, I might double layer it, because if I double layer it and make it stiffer, and also it will be like you know, you'd have the bling both sides, is what I'm thinking. What I might do, sort of like that. So if I do, layer it like that, no, that's fine. I'll do four. Yeah. I've got my count. Okay, four. So, 1, 2, 3, 4. Fold. That's better. Okay. And then I'll just go round up good there. Yeah, I think I'll do that. So I'm just going to cut. It together, and that will make it stiffer, and in turn will make it sort of stand up more. Otherwise I could use stiffen, I suppose, but do I want to take that long making this project? Probably not. So I'm going to do it this way instead, and that way you've got the bling showing on the inside and on the outside of the sleigh, rather than just sort of it like you know, one sided bling on one side. I know what I mean. So I'm just going to glue this into place, match them up. And that, so it'll be a bit like, because she's a snow queen, it'll be a bit like it's a crown on the back of the, on the back of the sleigh. It will pucker a little bit, probably. But if I add it further down, what I will do is I will start in the middle and then that way. So I'm going to glue it, hot glue it starting in the middle and then that way. It will be how I want it. There we go. And that way I can bring these sides to there. And I can always trim that up as well, but I will glue this to the back here as well, which will also make it stand up. So awesome. So she will sit in the back of her Snow Queen sleigh with this bit here. So. Oops. And I will cover that there just to tidy that up with a bit of trim. I don't think this is white, I think it's green, I'm not sure. Oh no. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to use this just to tidy that, finish that bit up there. I'm hoping that you can hear me okay and that hasn't been too loud with my fan on. Okay, so like I said, I'm just going to add that to the inside of there just to tidy that bit up. So that's what we've got for the back. Isn't that cool? That's our Snow Queen, the back. Icicle. So nice. Okay. I want to add some bits of bling or something to the, you know, these curly bits. I have to see, but I want that as her wand. I desperately need to, you know, like on the wheels and that, doing some, you know, bit, just some bling like that. What have I got here? Oh yes, that's sort of like on the. I'm going to do a bow, I think, and put the bow. But in order to do the bow, what I'm going to do, I'm going to use my bow maker, because my bow maker arrived. And I've got some absolutely beautiful ribbon that they sent me as well. So I got the Christmas theme, and I also got the wedding one. So I've got this ribbon, which is beautiful. It's going to go perfect with this because it's all frosty looking. Now this is out of the wedding kit, this ribbon, the wedding. Okay. Look at that. Isn't that just stunning? And then there's this. I'm going to use this. I have got ties, but there is that as well. So I'm going to use that because it's got a bit of iridescent in it. So I think those two will go beautifully together. And then I'm going to. Now I've got that one as well. Look, beautiful. So now I want a. No, I don't want a big bow. Now these do move. So I think I'm going to loop. That's my middle. Yes, that's the size of my bow. Now, okay, so I'm going to put our bow in our bow maker, our ribbon in our bow maker, and I want quite a. Full bow, so I'm going to wrap it round like so, and I think I'm going to do another one. So make sure you're, when you're doing the bow, that you're not wrapping it around these here. Okay, so there we go. So then I've got my piece of ribbon, and it's got like a little groove in here where you can slide your ribbon, and then you tie it. And then you just slide it off. And there we go. You have your beautiful double layered bow. Now let me just cut this one off. This one. Okay. So there is my beautiful bow. All you do is separate the room. Isn't that fab? So that is going on the back of my. And then I'm going to stick a bling piece in the middle of it. Thank you. And yes, like I heard Michelle mention it, but I know another lady mentioned it too. If you just add a dollar, very tiny dollar glue there, it just keeps the bows apart. Just stops them from closing up. On that one side. Oh, they're such pretty bows. So pretty. Okay, so I'm going to add that there. And then I'm going to put my big bling piece over the top. So I'm going to add that in the middle, like so. Oh, so cute. And then I'm going to stick this big bling. See that? Sorry, my big bow. And then I'm going to put this bling over the top. And I have to say, the bow maker is so easy. So easy. And like I said, I've tried some bow makers in my time. And I've... spent money on bow makers and ended up, because you know what it's like, you have to, you know, take them out, put them away, take them out, put them away, whereas this is so good because you can just leave it out. Okay, it looks like some look, isn't that so stunning? Look at that. Beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. And my son's wedding's coming up soon, so I'll definitely be using the bow maker for bows, for projects for that. So pretty. Love it. Okay. So there we go for now, I think. Let me make sure that's all stuck on. Oops. Oops. Beautiful. Love it. Okay, so now we've got our bow. We've got our piece here that looks like, you know, like the crown on the queen, which I might even use to make a crown actually, because I'm going to use, I want to make her a high collar, like a high, like she, okay, so like that. Just see how that's going. Those snowflakes turned out wonderful. I am such an untidy crafter, you would not believe. Okay, so. So, now what I'm going to do, I'm going to sort of grab a bunch of these together, like so, and then I'm going to glue them to my mat and then let them dry. Would help if you could see what I'm doing. So I'm just gluing this little cluster to my mat. I'll let it dry. I'm going to get some more. Put a top of glue on my mat and then glue these in place. And then when they dry, they will just lift off. So I'll just leave them to dry for a minute. More. This is fab. You can make these yourself, you know. With string. And I will show you. Doesn't matter because you won't see this end bit here because it will be covered up. But it's, again, it's great to use it as a filler for when you're doing the flowers. So, just stick it in the hot glue. Add some hot glue over the top. Okay, so when that one's dry, you can just pull it up, and there you go. Okay, and that way you don't have to worry about faffing. You don't have to faff about, you know, trying to get them to all stick or hold them together. So yeah. So. So then I think I'm just going to just here on this corner. Oops, make sure you can see what I'm doing. Just gonna add that there. Tell you what, these hot glue is doing my head in. And no, they're not quite dry yet. Let me stick this flower, I think. So I'm just adding a little flower cluster there. I'm going to do the same the other side. Okay, so I've done the same to the other side. I've added this light little with the flowers, the leaves, the white leaves. So I think that's quite cool. Okay. So okay, so what I'm going to do now, these are my little embellishment icicle I made. So I'm going to add these now sort of randomly up and around. So I've got sort of four for each side. So I've got four with the blue, there's eight in total, four with the blue facing up and four with the white facing up. So I'm going to, so if I add one there, white one there. So, see. So we've got all the icicles going up the side. So I will do the same this side. So what have we got to add? Just there. The white one at the back. Okay, that should leave me with two. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Maybe I didn't. Maybe I only did. Strange as that. It is so hot, it's unbelievable. Unbelievably hot. I am melting the time. Well, I'm not going to put that one on just yet because I'm sure I did four of each. So, oh, there it is. I've just found it. Oh, it was stuck to the bottom of the. I was falling on it. Oh, I'm annoying. Okay. Let's just sort of push that in. Right, okay, so I wanted to add one. Each to the back of the sleigh. So I've lost the other one again now. Okay. So I'll just glue this on and then I'll show you. And then that one there, so what I've done. Okay. So just added them just there. Like that. There we go. So I'm going to leave that for the moment.